Bridget, your daughter and son have been nurtured by your years of guidance and love. Today, these lays represent Jesse and Sean's eternal commitment and devotion to one another, as well as the joining of your two families. In a lay, the beauty of each individual flower is not lost when it becomes a part of the lay, but is enhanced because of the strength of its bond. As Jesse and Sean become partners in marriage, they ask for your affectionate love and support. Jim and Lori, Dan and Bridget, do you pledge to give your support and to continue to guide and love them on this day and all days to come? If so, please answer, we do.
We do.
We do.
Sean and Jesse, I can attest that theirs is a partnership freely chosen and built upon love, friendship, and respect for one another. A partnership that encourages first and foremost an enthusiasm for life and for their desire to share this life with one another. This shared endeavor is also one that they undertake with the full support of friends and family here with us today, as well as a broader community of people who are celebrating from afar. Marriage is a highly ambitious undertaking involving mutual sacrifice, persistent effort, and unending patience and trust. This wedding will serve as an important milestone in your relationship and involves the renewal and confirmation of those ideas and feelings that drew you together in the first place. As your relationship continues to grow and evolve, your shared purpose will guide you each to becoming better versions of yourselves, complementing each other's weaknesses and enhancing each other's strengths. Like many of us here today, Jesse and Sean first met at Washington State University. Although they were introduced during their freshman year, when they lived in adjoining dorms, it would take a few years for each of them to find their way back to each other. As with so many timeless romances that come out of Pullman, their relationship started on a Wednesday night at the Coop. Anyone that spent time at the Coop should know something about spending a few pitchers worth of time there in that little corner bar, and how it can give a certain sense of courage and confidence. And Jesse was no exception. She asked Sean out on their first date right then and there, and they've been inseparable ever since. Sean said that he could tell right away that Jesse was a strong and confident woman with a great sense of humor. His appreciation for Jesse's organization and capacity for seeing the big picture only drew them closer together. Jesse was first attracted to Sean's manners. She was struck by what a total gentleman he was, and then came to discover that his chivalry was earnest. It's not just Sean's killer dance moves and terrible, but lovable, dad jokes that Jesse loves about Sean, but more so, his dedication to work, friends, and family. Jesse and Sean, I think I speak for everyone here today when I say how thankful we are for that April evening at the Coop. Because not only did it eventually bring us all here to celebrate in this amazing setting, but also set you on the course of joyfully dedicating your lives to one another. Now, Sean and Jesse have asked Sean's sister Meredith to read a traditional Irish blessing.
May the raindrops fall lightly on your brow. May the soft winds freshen your spirit. May the sunshine brighten your heart. May the burdens of the day rest lightly upon you. And may God enfold you in the mantle of his love. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm on your face and the rain fall soft upon your heels. And until we meet again, my friend, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. May God be with you and bless you. May you see your children's children. May you be foreign misfortunes and rich in blessings. May you know nothing but happiness when you stay forward. May green be the grass you walk on. May green be the skies above you. And from this day forward, may the joys of today be those of tomorrow.
You've got a place to sit. Please be seated.
It's important.
Jesse and Sean, you have come to love each other deeply and sincerely. That love has given you the desire to unite in marriage and establish a life together. With this ceremony, you're dedicating yourselves to give happiness and well-being to one another. Your marriage is an act of faith. It must not be based on the hope of what the other will or will not do, might or might not become. How badly Sean beats... Excuse me. I'm going to go back one sentence. Your marriage is an act of faith. It must not be based on the hope of what the other will or will not do, might or might not become. How badly Sean beats Jesse at Jeopardy. Or how many seasons of The Bachelor does he make Sean? Rather, it must be based on the firm belief of your own individual worth and that of the other, and the shared belief that the more puppies there are in your lives, the better. Jesse and Sean, today you announce your love and lifelong commitment to one another in the presence of family and friends. We celebrate with you, and we wish you well. I imagine the marriage between Sean and Jesse will look a little something like the makings of a cocktail. Each individual part is blended together to make one well-balanced, and hopefully strong, drink. This unique cocktail represents the flowing of two lives into a single creation. In a cocktail, all the individual components of the drink, when poured together, can never be separated. It would be impossible to ever pull apart the exact drops that once belonged to the other. The blending of the drinks represents the union, not only of the two of them, but also their friends and families. The two glasses, once combined, become inseparable. They are forever entwined, just as the lives and love between Jesse and Sean.
Stand beside you wherever life takes us.
You walk Leo when you don't want to.
You don't want to.
To
treasure every moment that we have together.
To treasure every moment that we have together.
To trust and value your opinions.
To trust and value your opinions.
And to stand by your actions.
To stand by your actions.
I vow to never take your love for granted.
I vow to never take your love for granted.
And to always respect you.
And to always respect you.
I will be there to laugh with you.
I will be there to laugh with you.
And to love you through all our adventures in life together.
To love you through all our adventures in life together.
Sean, say. Jesse, I love you more than anyone.
Jesse, I love you more than anyone.
I vow to love you completely.
I vow to love you completely.
To make you laugh loudly.
To make you laugh loudly.
And to dance with you always.
To dance with you always.
I promise never to stop singing to you.
I promise to never stop singing
to you. Watch The Bachelor on Mondays.
Watch The Bachelor on Mondays.
Hold your laundry for you.
Hold your laundry for you.
I vow to believe in you, whatever you endeavor.
I vow to believe in you, whatever you endeavor.
And to care for you and to be your rock.
Care for you and to be your rock.
I promise to always be there for you.
I promise to always be there for you.
To share in your joys.
To share in your joys.
And to wipe away your tears.
And to wipe away your tears.
And no matter what comes, I will never leave your side.
No matter what comes, I will never leave your side.
One of the best man's please provide a ring.
Sean, with this ring.
I take you to be my constant friend.
I take you to be my constant friend.
My partner in adventure.
My partner in adventure.
And my love from this day forward.
And my love from this day forward.
Jesse, with this ring. I take you to be my constant friend.
I take you to be my constant friend.
My partner in adventure.
My partner in adventure.
And my love from this day forward. Sean, do you take Jesse to be your wife? To love her, care for her, respect her, and cherish her uniqueness as you enter into this union of love and trust? If so, please answer, I do.
I do.
Jesse, do you take Sean to be your husband? To love him, care for him, respect him, and cherish his uniqueness as you enter into this union of love and trust? If so, please answer, I do. Now, by the power vested in me by the beautiful state of Hawaii, it gives me great pleasure to pronounce the two of you, Mr. and Mrs. Kusama.
Where those apple bottom beans are? But not on a real team.